have been recognized. Ravikant, but the research analyst at IDBI Capital joins us first. Ravikant, that is the statement that everything that the regulator told us has been recognized in the current quarter itself. What is your comment on the bank's numbers? Ravi, can you hear me? Okay. All right, Mayuresh of Angel Broking has also joined us. We will dial back to Ravikant in a minute. Mayuresh, what have you made of the NPA numbers? Fresh NPAs of 2,082 crores were added. And the bank says that they have recognized everything that the regulator wanted them to recognize.
Evening, Lata. I think clearly, if this is a statement that the bank is probably putting forth, I think our expectations was that the cleanup should happen in this quarter or the next. So largely, I think a lot of cleaning up has probably started taking place. And even if you go by the provisioning number or the provision coverage that you just mentioned, it is a testimony that probably things are working in that direction. So clearly, I think the asset quality, in our opinion, has worsened off a little bit than what we probably expected, both on the GNPA and then net NPA part.
Okay. Do stay on, Mayuresh. Himendra Hazari, the veteran banking analyst, also joins us now. Himendra, what have you made? 30 basis point increase, 2,000 crores more recognized, and the bank saying that it has fully recognized the necessary impairment and the provisioning impact of the asset reclassification according to the RBI's assessment. So everything the RBI wanted has been recognized in the current quarter itself.
Firstly, that 2,082 crores, I think, is within the analyst expectations of slippages.
Okay.
Secondly, is that although they may have recognized whatever the RBI wanted them to recognize, the fact still remains that today the rupee dollar crossed 68. And Axis Bank has, like a lot of other banks, has a huge exposure to corporate India, and corporate India has taken on a lot of dollar borrowings or foreign currency loans. Now, all this is going to come under pressure at the moment the rupee depreciates, and the rupee has been depreciating for some time. So, although Axis Bank and other banks may be conforming fully with RBI regulations for this quarter, as I see it, there is more pain to come for the entire banking sector, including Axis Bank.
Okay, so even with this result, where a lot of the poison is recognized, you are not in a mood to recommend a buy on the share?
No, I'm not. Because there is today, there is great deal of stress in corporate India as well as even in other sectors of agrarian India as well. And I think the banking sector, even though they may be saying that we are recognizing and complying with everything that RBI wants, now what about the exposures to the huge business groups, which are on tender hooks? Those do not belong to those 150 accounts that RBI has identified. So what is the status of those accounts? I'm sure Axis Bank, like all other banks, would have significant exposures to those industrial groups.
Okay, so you're waiting for more pain to come out. You wouldn't touch any of the banks now.
I think it should be expected, and analysts and the market should expect that the pain should be, should be greater. There's more pain to come. That should be the expectation.
All right. Well, stay on, Himendra. We have Ravikant Bhatt once again reconnected. Ravikant, you must have had time to go through the press release. Your first thoughts?
Like I was saying, if Axis Bank has indeed recognized a lot of the pain which they claim to have, then that sounds heartening, but I would still look forward to what more color management has to add, because whatever has been recognized would be, what RBI has asked them to do in this particular quarter. And like a few couple of days back, RBI put out a press release saying that in the meeting of the bankers and other representatives from NBFCs and ARCs, a lot of suggestions had been received, and they were looking further into how to take forward the resolution of stressed assets. So I would believe that this is not the end of it, and to use the phrase that you use, the entire poison being recognized, well, there might be some more poison left to be recognized. All in all, the profit is better than what we had expected. So, I would take some solace out of that. particular number, but let us not comfort ourselves into believing that it's all you know, done and dealt with. Let's look forward to what more color the management can add.
Okay, some more details where the net advances are up 21% for the quarter, with retail advances which are again leading the growth up around 27% odd. Ravikant, just based on what they've reported this time round, which is basically an NII growth which is maintained at 15%, your profit growth which is actually higher than the single digits that the street was expecting, and provisions which were largely stable Q-on-Q, along with the asset quality being recognized, with all of these factors taken into consideration, with no sale of loans to asset reconstruction companies as well, do you then expect maybe Axis to possibly move up based on the fact that the market conditions would provide?
See, based on the you know, operational performance which they have reported, I have you know, largely been expecting that they are going to do well on the NIMs, because the CASA franchise, overall the liability franchise has been stable, the asset mix has been holding up well, they have pushed very aggressively into the retail assets. Therefore, as far as the top line, the spreads, the operating profit is concerned, I don't think anyone on the street for that matter has got much doubts about how Axis Bank is going to perform over there. The you know, bigger doubts start creeping in when you, you know, start looking below the operating profit line, and that is where you should be looking at more keenly on how that's going to shape up.
Okay, Mayuresh, what's your take? Will you start buying Axis now after its dip below the 400 rupee mark, and the poison, the NPAs coming in line with street estimates, or will you still wait?
So clearly, Lata, as I said, I think a couple of quarters is somewhere where we still believe that the cleaning up act will continue, and if one goes by the earth that management has probably laid out, again, I think some pain would still be there within the system itself. So I think I'm not doubting whether everything has been recognized at this point of time, but again, I think the management commentary thereof would probably add more stability in terms of our outlook. Clearly, in terms of estimates, I think it has exceeded our estimates in terms of how the bottom line has probably grown for the bank. The provisioning, again, lesser than what we had estimated. And again, I think NIMS and the top line a tad bit better than what we had probably envisaged. So clearly, I think the operating performance has been good. But clearly, I think one really needs to understand how the asset quality is expected to pan out and whether the entire pain is actually out of the system specific in relation to the banks. So whether buy this bank, probably as I mentioned earlier as well, the de-risking strategy will be to buy a bunch of these banks because you're not really sure of the next two quarters how the asset quality will pan out.
But Axis would be in that bunch.
Oh yes, Lata. Oh yes.
All right. Okay. Thank you very much, Mayuresh, Hemendra, and Ravikant, for joining us in this conversation. Well, the sum and substance is both the profit and the net interest income number are better than what Ekta's poll threw up, but the asset quality number still leaves a bit of worry. The bank has stated in no uncertain terms that it has recognized everything that was mandatorily required of it by the regulator. Nevertheless, despite the number itself, 2,072 crores of fresh gross NPLs recognized in the third quarter, coming within analyst expectations. The niggling worry we got from all our analysts is that with the economy still not looking like stabilizing, with commodity prices still falling, the rupee still slightly weakening, there could be more pain to come, and Axis is, as a big bank, exposed to a lot of big corporate borrowers, and therefore the pain will not perhaps be over. There were some buy recommendations, but it merely said that, as Angel's Mayuresh Joshi said, Axis will be one of the many banks people will start nibbling in. Ekta, you want to add to anything?
Yes, absolutely. Well, just the fact that the NII and the profit was actually better than, or the profit was better than expectations, so maybe that should cushion the asset quality stress, which they've possibly, you know, recognized going forward as well.
All right, we have to wrap up this edition of A Market, the Fear Factor, on that note. But stay tuned to CNBC TV 18. There is lots coming from Davos, from Governor Rajan, and a lot of domestic developments on the power sector from New Delhi. Back in a minute.